Ryan is a young footballer, goalkeeper, who's been at Inter Milan for a couple of years at the time that Martin arrives. And he sort of takes Martin under his wing. So it's a sort of older brother relationship, really. This kid lands there, doesn't speak the language, can barely communicate with most people. They only speak through English, and Ryan's an American, and so he speaks English, and so they form a little bond, and he starts giving Martin little tips about how to navigate this very cutthroat and quite sinister world that he's found himself in. I think it is very specific about the pressures that young players go through. You know, it's a very cutthroat world, and I have a cousin who's a footballer, and you know, I know people who've been in one way or another associated to that world, but it's the pressure and the money at stake, and there's so much that makes it cinematically very interesting. But I think beyond that, there's a universality to it, as it's looking at how do we deal with our mental health problems, how do we struggle with pressure, how do we struggle with finding ourselves going down one path and then thinking we maybe could have gone to another. I wouldn't want to be prescriptive and say the film has this to say or that to say. Everyone will take something a bit different from it. But I think the important thing is that it opens a dialogue about mental health, yes, in football, but hopefully also in society in a sort of wider sense. I think that's something we're starting to talk about, but there's still a long way to go to really be getting into those conversations in the kind of depth that we need to be able to support people who are struggling.
So someone whose career started by being thrust into one of the biggest film franchises of all time, were you able to relate to any of that sense of pressure or that instantaneous kind of pubescent stardom?
Yeah, it's funny. There were things which certainly rang true to me from my experiences. Obviously, I was lucky enough to be in a very supportive environment. You know, Harry Potter was a wonderful place to discover the industry, as it were. I started working on those films when I was 11 and stayed till I was 21. You know, it wasn't like being sort of thrown in, chewed up and spat out. And that had to do with how supportive everyone was and how considerate everyone was and the experience of everyone else. Because although the young cast were, you know, we sort of found ourselves in completely new territory, everybody else very much knew what they were doing and knew how to look after us. But, you know, that said, I think acting like football can be a very high-pressure industry with a lot of money at stake and a lot of pressure put on young people very suddenly. And there's that side of it, which is the public eye, and how do you deal with that when that's something that is suddenly on you? So, yes, I think there will always be... I think there will be equivalencies across various industries, because really it's about pressure and mental health, and a lot of people will find their own ways to associate with that and their own points of comparison.
In terms of that lovely Potter family, how special was it for you to be a part of that unique celebration that you guys all had together, getting together for the reunion, the anniversary?
Yeah, that was very nice. It was funny. That was... I didn't really know what exactly it was going to be. There was sort of like, oh, we're having a 20th... anniversary celebration. I thought, well, is it a party? And I don't know, we're filming something. But it was the main thing for me was just a chance to get together and to see people I haven't seen in a long time. And that's always lovely. And to, you know, celebrate what we went through and the impact that those films had. People loved that special. People kept saying to me, oh, it was so great to see everyone back together. And you sort of realize, I think from the inside, maybe you. Not that it becomes mundane, but it's something you're used to, right? And so it was another chance to see how much it had affected people and how much people were moved by those films, and so grateful to have been a part of them, really.
What are you moving on to next?
I have another film which has just come out in Brazil. I think it might come out in London, or in the UK, rather, called Midge the Provisoria. But I don't really know into all the details in terms of the release. But I'm filming something at the moment. And I've got another film which I'm jumping onto straight after that. The second of those two will be out this Christmas.